Hello children, welcome to AIMS India's online classes. Children, today we will be continuing the question and answers from previous state and Olympiad examinations and from the topic water. Okay children, and our subject is science. The 44th question, water can be found underground. Where does underground water come from? Okay, water can be found underground. As we said, water can be also found underground. No, where does underground water come from? Where do we get this underground water? Okay, and the options are, it has made underground when the earth formed. Long ago, cave people stored water underground. Water seeps into ground from rain and it flows up from the center of the earth. Okay children, so and the correct option is C, that is water seeps into ground from rain. So whenever the rain occurs, now we'll get water and that water is going to sink into the ground. Okay, so that is how underground water is available. Okay children, clear? Yes. Now and the 45th question, water pollution can be caused by either decrease in use of pesticides, oil spills from ships, reuse of industrial water by factories, recycling of water, used water at home. So children, if you observe this A, C and D, these three causes will avoid water pollution. Okay, because if we are using less number of pesticides, then we can control water pollution. No, so this option, A option, and reuse of industrial water by factories. If you are again reusing the industrial water which is used by the factories, again pollution can be controlled. D option also, recycling of used water at home. If we are recycling, we are using the used water at home. Suppose the water which we use to wash the rice at home, if we can use them for plants, then we can save the water and also we can save the pollution. No. So that is why these three are not the correct answers. The only correct answer is B option. Oil spills from ships. Because ships, where do they travel, children? They travel on the surface of the water. No. If oil is going to spill from the ship, then that water is going to get polluted. Okay. So that is why B is the correct answer. 46th question. Dash covers about 75% of the earth and is one of the most abundant substances on earth. Dash covers about 75% of the earth. So which substance is covered about 75% of the earth surface? And it is one of the most abundant substances. Abundant in the sense large in quantity. Okay. Which is available in lot of volume or lot of quantity. What is that? Answer is either water, salt, land or metal. And the answer is water. Okay children, so 75% of the earth is water and 25% of the earth is land. Okay, and in this 75% of water, even though this is so much available, only 1% is available for drinking. I mean, drinking water is available only for 1%. Clear, children? Yes. Now, 47th question. When Puneet was on vacation in Kashmir, he could see clouds passing by. What are clouds made up of? Okay, children. So, sometimes we also see clouds passing by. No. Same like that, even Puneet, when he was in vacation, he was on vacation in Kashmir, he also saw this scenery where the clouds was were passing by. What are clouds made up of? Either hot steamed water, hot air, sand and water, or tiny water droplets. And the answer is D, children. That is tiny water droplets. Next question, 48th question. Which of the following substances do not dissolve the water? Which of the following substances do not dissolve the water? In which substances, which substances are not going to dissolve in the water? Okay, which are not going to dissolve in the water? Either sugar, sherbet, lemon juice, or oil. This is not sherbet. Children, this is sherbet. Okay, this is B-A-T-H, sorry. Sherbet, lemon juice, and oil. Sherbet is nothing but a type of juice mix, okay, which we are going to mix in the water, and then we will drink it as a cool drink. So that substances, whatever are used in making this sherbet, that is the juice, they are going to dissolve in the water. Even sugar also dissolves, even lemon juice also dissolve. Only left is oil. So oil will not be dissolved in the water. Clear, children? Now 49th question. Meena has a hand pump in front of her house. Its water is generally used for cleaning of utensils and washing of clothes. However, the water does not form enough lather with the soap. This water is. See, children, we are going to wash our clothes and clean our utensils. No. For doing this work, what do we use? We use some liquids and we use some detergents, that is soap and some surf and all that. No. So, Meena, she also cleaned her utensils and washed her clothes. But what water she has used? She has used the water from the hand pump. Okay, she was having a hand pump in front of her house. She used that water which has come from the hand pump and she cleaned her clothes and the utensils. So what happened? There was enough lather with the soap. So when she was using the soap to clean her clothes and the utensils, there was not enough lather. That is the foam, children. Now you can see that white color foam from the soap. No, so this was not enough. So she was having very little foam. So why was this? Because this water is soft, hard, sore, or impure. And the answer is hard. Okay, answer is hard. So hand pump, well, and all these are underground water sources. The underground water is hard. It is not soft like our tap water. Okay, suppose if you use a tap water and do the same work like utensils, clean the utensils or wash the clothes, you will get much foam from the soap. No, as the water was hard from this underground and she got it from the hand pump, so she was not getting enough foam from the soap. Okay, children? So the answer is B option. Clear? And now the next question. Raju is helping to conserve water when he dash. Raju is helping to conserve water. Conserve water in the sense save water when he dash. So Raju was trying to save the water. How? Like when he brushes his teeth with water running from the tap, washes the vegetables under a running tap, uses water from the drain to cook, or turns off taps when not in use. So the first three options, children, if you read carefully, these three are of wastage of water. We are not saving by these three things. Only the option is D, like turns off taps when not in use. So Raju tried to save water by turning off taps when not in use. Clear? D is the correct answer. 51st question. By which of the following ways can we reuse water? By which of the following ways can we reuse water? A is use water that is drained out from the washing machine to wash the toilet. Use water that is drained out from the washing machine to water plants. C is use water collected from rain to wash vegetables. Or collect water from tap leaks to cook. See children, use water that is drained out from the washing machine to wash the toilet. Yes, so this is the answer. Like, how can we reuse it? Because this water, again, it can be used for cleaning the toilets. No, we cannot use it for some other purpose. Like, as it is said, we cannot use for the plants because that water may also contain some detergent liquids, no, surf, soap, powders. So, which is again not good for watering the plants. No, but you can use this for cleaning the toilets. Okay, children. And here C option also is not correct because you cannot use rainwater to wash vegetables. Sometimes in rainwater, you will also have small germs. Okay. And D, collect water from tap leaks to cook. So, this is also wrong choice. That is, you cannot cook from the water which is collected from the leakages of the tap. Okay, children. So, A is the correct answer. 52nd question. Which two processes in the water cycle ensure a continuous supply of water? So, what are the two processes in the water cycle which are going to ensure, which are going to give us a continuous supply of water, which are ensure in the sense it like confirm, okay, like a guarantee, which is going to confirm a continuous supply of water, either boiling or melting, or evaporation and freezing, or condensation and melting, or condensation and evaporation. And the answer is condensation and evaporation. So, because of this condensation and evaporation, there is a continuous supply of water. Okay, children. Now, 53rd question. Which would be the best usage of rainwater? Which would be the best usage of rainwater? How best we can use the rainwater? Either you can use it to cook rice or use it to rinse your vegetables or use it to wash your clothes or use it to wash your veranda. So, what will be the answer, children? Okay. Can you guess? It is use it to wash your clothes. So, you can use it to wash your clothes. Clear? Yes, now. 54th question. We get rain through the continuous dash and dash of water. Dash and water. So, here, how do we get rain through the continuous of which processes? Okay, like either radiation and evaporation, evaporation and condensation, melting and boiling, boiling and freezing. Boiling and freezing. So, again, the answer is evaporation and condensation. Now, water cycle is nothing but the same process. Now, because of water cycle only, we are getting rain. So, the continuous movement of water cycle and getting rain through the continuous process are both the same. Like evaporation and condensation. 55th question. What is the change of state when water freezes to ice? So when water is going to freeze to ice, what is the change of state? Now you are having three states of matters. No, solid, liquid and also gas. Then when water is going to freeze to ice, so from which state to which state it is going to change? So either from liquid state to solid state, or solid state to liquid state, or gaseous state to solid state, or liquid state to gaseous state. How, in which state is water, children? Water is in liquid state. No, I just wrote L here. Ice is ice. It is in solid state. So now what will be their answer? A option. That is, it is changing from liquid state to solid state. Clear, children? Yes, now. And 56th question. The waste water is treated to. The waste water is treated to. So, how we are going to treat the waste water? Okay, to promote water activities, to provide suitable conditions for aquatic life, to prevent spreading of diseases of water, or to provide water for use in factories. Okay, the waste water is treated for all these purposes. That is 1, 2, 3 and 4. To promote water activities. In the sense, we are going to recycle the water. No, waste water treatment is nothing but the recycling the water which is used. Again, that waste water is used for some other purposes. Okay. So, that is known as waste water treatment. And to provide suitable conditions for aquatic life. The animals which live in water, and to prevent spreading of diseases of water, okay, and to provide water for use in factories. Clear, children? Now, 57th question, children. There is some water in a jug. All the water is poured into an empty pan from the jug. What happens to the amount of water? See, children, here you are having the jug in this picture and it is of a different shape. Now, again here you have got another pan which is in circle shape. No, so this is a long container which is horizontal, which is vertical, and this is a circular shape horizontal container. So, this jug water is poured into this pan. Then what happens to the amount of water? In the sense, the quantity of water. Will it decrease or will it become more, or will it will remain the same? Answer is, it remains the same. Only thing is, here because the container was in this shape, we were able to see the water until this level. When it is poured into the pan, again, I mean, it has spread rectangularly here. No, across. But the amount of water is the same. But it is not visible as it is in the jug. Okay, children, clear? Now, 58th question. Equal amount of water is poured into four uncovered containers. Okay, so there is equal amount of water which is poured into four uncovered. If you see, it is not covered. Any container is not covered with the lid. Okay, the four containers are left on a table in a classroom for 3 days. The four containers are left. This uncovered, four containers are left on a table for 3 days. From which container do you think the water will evaporate fastest? Okay, so there are these four containers of different shapes and sizes. No, children? So from which container does the water evaporate at the fastest rate? And the answer is from the D container. Why? Because this is having a wide open. Okay, because the opening surface has got, I mean the width is more when compared to the other three. So because it has got a wide opening, the water, it will evaporate as the fastest rate. Okay, children, clear? So D is the correct answer. 59th question, what is correct regarding water? So you are having four statements in the answer. So which statement is correct? It is a liquid in all the three states of matter. It has no definite volume and shape. It exists in all three states of matter, or it has definite shape and no definite volume. See children, we are talking about water here. Okay. So the first statement, what does it tell? It is a liquid in all three states of matter. Is it true? No. It is not liquid. No. So when it is in liquid state, water is like water only. When it becomes in a solid state, it turns like ice. When it is a gaseous state, it becomes water vapor. No. And so that is why first one is wrong. B is, it has no definite volume and shape. Again, this is also wrong. No. Why? Because, so if you observe children here in this picture, so it has got different shapes. Now here, for example, we have taken four containers and we have poured the same amount of water in this. According to the shape of the container, even the water has got its shapes. No. Clear? And its volume also. Clear? So that is why even the second option is also wrong. And third one, it exists in all the three states of matter. Yes, as we said, so it is in liquid state, solid state, and all. Children, regarding the fourth point, that is D option, it has definite shape but no definite volume. No, this is also wrong, because it will take the shape according to its container. No, so we cannot say that it has definite shape. Clear, children? Yes, so that is why C option is the correct one. Now the 60th question, which of the below conditions is required for water cycle to occur continuously? So you are having three conditions here in the options. So which condition is required, is needed for water cycle to occur continuously? Either there must be heat, or there must be light, or there must be air in water. There must be air in water. So which one is correct, children? Yes, the first one, that is there must be heat. That is only first option. A is the correct answer. Why? Only through heat, evaporation and then condensation takes place. Because of that, we also get rain. No, this is what about the water cycle is. The continuous process of water cycle is. So for this, you need heat. Okay, children. 61st question. The below process is known as, the below process is known as, so what is that? Water changing changing into ice. After losing heat, water when loses heat, it changes into ice. So what is it called as? Either melting, condensation, sublimation, or freezing. And the answer is freezing. No, if you keep water, children, in the freezer, what will happen? No, it is going to lose the heat and it change into ice. No, it becomes ice. So this is because of freezing. Okay. Now 62nd question. In the given figures, A and B change in the state of water is taking place. Name the process in both the setups respectively. See children, here you are having two pictures, whereas A and also the B. Okay, so this is one picture and this is one picture. So here what is happening? Change in the state of water. Change in the state of water is taking place. So name the process in both the setups respectively. So change in the state of water is, the water is changing into water vapor. That is the gaseous stage. No. And what, but the process are different. The process are different. So what are they? Either fermentation and boiling, or boiling and precipitation, or boiling and evaporation, or condensation and evaporation. And the answer is C, that is boiling and evaporation. See here, here we are boiling the water. We are boiling the water by producing the fire. No, here also water vapor is generated. No, and this is nothing but evaporation only. But here we are boiling it. But here, because of the sun heat, the water is evaporating, which we call it as evaporation. No, so that is why C, that is boiling and evaporation. Clear children? Here, the change that is occurring in the given figure is, the change that is occurring in the given figure is, what is happening here? The ice is melted as water. Now, what is this? Either boiling, freezing, melting, or evaporation. As I said, melting. Ice is melting as water. Clear, children? Yes, now. And the next question is 64th one. Take some muddy water in a beaker. Filter it in the different ways as shown below. Which of the following is the best method of filtration? So you have taken a muddy water in a beaker, and we are going to filter it in the different ways as it is there in the figure. See here. Okay. And which one has got the best method of filtering water? Okay. Which is called as filtration. So here, see children. So we have tied up a very clean cloth to the mouth of the container or a pot. And we are just pouring the water. This is one method. This is another method is, we have kept a strainer. We have kept a strainer and we are again pouring the water, filtering the water through the strainer. And another one is, we have placed filter paper, in a beaker, and then we are pouring it, the water, through filter paper. So where do we get the best water? In the third way. Why? Because the filter paper is going to get all the impurities settled down at the end of this beaker or the strainer, and only the pure water is going to get into the container. Whereas through cloth or through this strainer, it is not possible. I mean, it is not possible in such pure way. Okay, children. So, that is why C is the correct answer. 65th question. What must have happened to the water in the tumbler X in 10 minutes before it reached the state in the tumbler Y? Okay. See here. This is X, children. X tumbler and Y tumbler. And there is water, and we are just calculating the water. We are calculating the water. Calculating in the sense, we are just testing the temperature of the water here. See the thermometer here and here also. Okay. And inside this, the level of heat is shown until this area. Here the level of temperature is shown until this area. Now initially in the beginning stage it was like this. After 10 minutes the water temperature has been increased to this level. Okay, so why it is? Because the tumbler was placed in a refrigerator. The tumbler was heated on a stove. Ice tumbler was added to the water, or the tumbler was left untouched. So as I said in the beginning, the tumbler was heated on the stove. So when it was heated on the stove, so the temperature of the tumbler water has been increased. So that is why the level of temperature also has been increased. Clear, children? Yes. Now 66th question, children. Which of these statements about ice and water is or are true? So which is the statement true about ice and water? And the options are both boil at 100 degrees Celsius, both have same temperature, or when heated the ice cubes will directly change to steam, or both are different states of water. And the answers are 1 and 4. That is, both boil at 100 degrees Celsius and both are different states of water. Okay, children. So B is the correct option. Clear? 67th question. After stepping out of the air-conditioned school bus, Kelvin's spectacles became misty. Okay. Misty is what, children? It's like some type of snow or fog covered on the glass area. Okay, that is misty. Some type of, it's not only on glass area, you can see this anywhere. But because here we are talking about Kelvin spectacles, so I have said that on that specs, that is on the glasses. Okay, when Kelvin has stepped down from his air-conditioned school bus. Air-conditioned school bus in the sense which has got the AC, where they will get cool air. No, after he steps out from that bus, his spectacles became misty. Okay, so with the water and all. Like as we see, when we take out the glass of water from the fridge and cool water from the fridge and we keep it aside on the table, after some time you can see some water droplets coming out of the outer surface of the glass. No, same here also it happened to the glasses. Why is this process taken place? Because of melting or because of freezing or because of evaporation or because of condensation? And the answer is condensation. Now what happens? The cool air, what happens? It is going to change as water. No. So when it is exposed to heat, it is going to change as water. Water vapor changes into water. So that is why we call that as condensation. Amit made a cone of blotting paper as shown in the figure. He poured sandy water into it. What will come out into the jar? Okay, children. So Amit made a cone of blotting paper. See here. This is the cone made of blotting paper. And what is blotting paper? So if you pour any liquid in this blotting paper, either not only water, oil, kerosene, any liquid, it is going to absorb it very quickly. Okay. So the total liquid will be absorbed by the paper. Okay. And along with this liquid, he poured sandy water in it. He poured sandy water in it. What will come out from the jar? Okay. So here, because it is a blotting paper, even though he poured sandy water, nothing is going to come out into the jar. Why? Because as this is a blotting paper, the water will be absorbed. It is absorbed completely. And the sand, anyway, it is not going to come out from this paper. So that is why neither sand nor water is the answer. Clear, children? Neither sand nor water. Okay? Yes, that is D option is the correct answer. Clear? Yes, now. So we are going to end here, children. So hope you have understood. So again, please revise all these question and answers. And I'm going to stop here. We'll be continuing in tomorrow's session. Until then, take care and